once again, you listen to our dulcet tones. Because.
And the sound of those motorbikes.
Yes.
Let's try that again.
Nobody gives a fuck who you are.
There were some words.
Yep.
They came.
Certainly had some words there.
They came spewing out of our mouths.
Indeed.
Take them how you want them.
We present them without.
Clothes.
Clothes.
We're naked now.
Completely. And that's quite impressive, I must say.
Oh, yeah. But not properly naked, because, you know.
7/8.
7/8 naked. Boxes only.
Yep.
Plums inside. Plums covered.
It's cold out. Where was I going? I don't know what I was going to say.
Yeah. It has been cold today.
It was a cold, crisp day. It was a beautiful day. But it was like the epitome of autumn.
Yeah. Freezing. The morn.
Freezing cold with clear blue sky.
Yeah. Turning into quite nice in the afternoon. North of Taylor, south of Taylor.
Fisher, dogger, bite.
Oh, the shipping forecast is so weird. And yeah. It's the second time we brought it up now.
Do you think there are shipping forecasts in other parts of the world? There must be.
Yeah.
Like,
I would be.
I reckon Scandinavia must have one.
They must. And I wonder whether it's presenting the same way.
Yeah. Does it sound the same?
Yeah. Or, you know, mackerel sardine, good to fair.
Yeah. I also.
I think we have to find out.
I think we have to find out, yeah.
Well, I say we, you.
Okay, I'll
that's,
do it.
That's your job for next
that's
time.
That's my job for next week. Mm-hmm. All right. Next time on Meanderthals.
Yes, other countries have a shipping forecast.
And here we go. And
that, glorious!
Yeah, it'll be like, yeah, I'll just tour the world with different shipping forecasts.
Yeah.
I quite like the idea of having useless pub quiz knowledge in my head.
Yeah.
So, like, memorising things like memorise the capitals of the 50 states of America, for example.
Yes. Animaniacs song? Yeah.
Well, I've not. I've not done it, but yeah, you know, because I'm not an American and it doesn't come up that often.
Yeah.
But it would be kind of a cool like little party piece. But the other one I really wanted to do was memorize the shipping forecast regions and their locations.
Oh.
That would be. Oops, excuse me. That's a good party trick, I think.
That is a good party trick.
Like, completely niche and slightly weird.
Oh, definitely niche.
But I would love to be able to do that.
To be able to go into a party and say, would anybody care to see my party trick? I can name all the shipping forecast zones and where they relate to.
Whereabouts are you from the country? Oh, really? I know what the shipping forecast region for that coastline is.
And they will go, the shipping what? And you will go, okay.
You're too young for me. Bye.
But actually, just before I go, somebody else?
Hey, it might work. Maybe there needs to be a dating app for that, to find somebody based on your shipping forecast region.
Based on your really weird niche knowledge.
Yeah.
Nisha, like, you know, maybe a portmanteau of niche and Tinder.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. There's plenty of niche.
Do you know about, right, shipping forecasts. I know a little bit about that. Swipe right. 60s wrestling. I know nothing about this. Swipe left.
It'd be like... Yeah, it'd be like the mastermind of dating.
Mm.
What is your specialist subject?
There's an app in that.
There is an app in that.
There's an app in that. Quick, no, I'm editing this all out. Quick.
Nisha. I think plenty of niche.
Plenty of niche. Nisha, I barely even know her.
Yeah.
Hey, every time one comes up, I'm going to hit it out of the park. I've actually got another idea for an app.
Oh, yeah.
Which... is potentially handy for men because talking about potentially socially awkward situations, as we have done before.
Yes.
If I've edited this correctly.
As
previously mentioned, I like looking at women in leggings because, to quote the wrestler Billy Gunn's theme tune,
I'm a nice man. Yeah, I'm a nice man.
And so I like to look at women's bums in leggings because a hell of a lot of them seem to be wearing them And that's just like, there's that bum. There it is. True just fact. Out there around. However, yeah. However, there is sometimes that point where they turn around and you see their face and you go, oh, how old are you?
Oh.
Because there's that worrying thing of like, oh. So what I want to invent is essentially something that can almost basically kind of determine to within a couple of years how old a wearer of leggings is based on things like their walk and their body makeup and what have you, their stride, their strut, their gait.
Good use of word there.
Exactly.
Well done.
G-A-I-T.
Mm.
Don't you worry. See, we're educational. We're perverts. But we're educational perverts.
Yeah. That was the alternative name for this podcast.
Yes. Briefly segueing, have you heard that Neil deGrasse Tyson is one of the people who's supposed to have just been raping women now?
What?
Yeah, Neil deGrasse Tyson. This is an allegation that in the 70s or 80s, when he was a young lecturer, there's... may have been unwanted shenanigans that have occurred.
He was a young lecturer, but also a young lecturer.
That's a good one. I enjoyed that one.
Thanks.
That's my enjoying it noise. You do not want to hear me orgasm.
You don't hear your orgasm, no. Your wedding night was weird.
Oh, man, I will tell you. When your wedding night, you don't got time for sex. You are absolutely shattered. It is a long day.
Yeah.
Like, it is tiring. And then you just don't have sex ever again. Ladies.
with each other, anyway.
No, yes. Well, story of my life. Even when I've tried to do it with other people, they've never been very receptive either, so...
Meh. No, I was segueing it. Never mind. Talking about masturbation again.
Yes.
There you go.
And
so, come on.
This app.
Yeah.
Which will, like I say, ascertain the age of a woman. And it will essentially give you a scale of how bad you should feel as a human, or as a man. How bad you should feel as a man is what it will do.
By perving on this person in leggings.
Yes, right. So you'll notice someone in leggings and you go, right, before I begin to potentially ogle and perhaps follow them for longer than I should do, let me get my phone up. Da-da-da-da-da. 15, look away!
What you're suggesting then is not only are you going to be ogling at girls in leggings, but you're also going to be taking creepy shots of them.
Yes, I'm also going to integrate it with Snapchat.
Okay. And then you're going to develop an app that will tell you if you should be going to jail or not.
Exactly, yes.
Do you have a name for it?
Evidence. Evidence against the accused.
Oh, God.
I do not. That's research and development. Yeah. That's not my area.
Suggestions on a postcard.
Yes. Suggestions written on a pair of leggings. Used, preferably. Post them to P.O. Box 42069. Lel.
Lels.
Care of the Meanderthals.
Care of TotalMemesRus.com. Alright, I like this idea.
Yeah. But, you know, it is that thing where young people nowadays... Like, some of them are worryingly grown up, and I know for a fact that at some point I must have looked at what would be classed as a girl in leggings, and I would just be like, oh. And
did you feel bad?
But that's it. I'm feeling bad in myself. I'm not judging her for wearing them, but I am judging you all for wearing them. You should know better, because there are men lecturing.
Are you putting yourself out there as a warning to all women?
Yes. I am man.
Yeah.
I'm not the worst man. In fact, I would consider myself towards the good end of man. And look at me.
Wow.
Look at me.
Wow.
I'm a fucking cunt.
Well, women, I think you can do better than my friend here.
Yes. So, Olaf. still looking for one of the old... one of the old ladies. Putting it out there? Yeah, yeah. Ladies.
He is putting it out there. Just put it away, please.
Yes.
I don't want to see that.
Ladies.
I thought we covered this.
Olaf wants you on his face.
I am amenable to it.
Yes. He will wear you like a feed bag. And baby, he's a hungry house.
Yeah. Just in case you needed any more encouragement, I have actually been learning how to breathe through my ears. So, well, I wouldn't say I'm on the prowl.
Well, it's probably better you don't phrase it that way, no.
It gets you into trouble.
Maybe I'll set about trying to find you a woman. I'll probably just end up getting lost in their arse, though.
Yeah, it's always the way, isn't it?
Yes.
Just try and wrangle one towards me in some way.
Yes, I'll maybe just shove the ones I'm not looking at as much towards you.
Thanks.
Forcibly, you, him, do, make, do things, yes.
I'm amazed that you got a woman.
Yeah. I can imagine that if, should I have not had any interaction with the human that I am married to, I would probably not be a virgin now, but my bedpost would not be full of notches. I feel like I'd be that guy. I can't remember if I've talked about this already on the cast, but I remember being 17 and partying at New Year's. I was obviously too young to be in the club because you meant to be 18 to be there.
He was all up in the club.
Going back to a previous topic of my body confidence / self-confidence, being in the club, and I would probably say a young woman because I'm reckoning from what I can remember, she was about 20, probably a student, started dancing with me. And I was just like, oh, I'm not really good at this. And she was like, it's fine. She was absolutely leathered. She was off her face. It was a situation that her friend physically came over, grabbed her, and said, no, get away. And...
ouch.
Yeah. Now, what I want to believe is that her friend was slightly more sober and was like, I don't think that boy should necessarily be in here. Let's not get you in any trouble, missy. And it was not. That guy looks like a bag of potatoes that's been shit in. Get away.
Wow.
However, natural self-deprecation and self-loathing.
Yeah, it does leave me. You go to that interpretation.
Yeah, it leads me towards that. You know, there's always a guy in school who's like 13 and he's already had sex with about 4 literal girls. And,
ew.
Yeah. I mean, this is just going off topic. Hey, you know, this is one of those that's just going to go out there. Personally, I lost my virginity just when I was 17. I was getting towards the end of it. And that's, I would say for nowadays, that is actually quite an old age to be losing your virginity based on what statistics show.
Statistics, whatever. People lie. How? This is the other thing. Is
lies,
that people still
damn
lie.
Lies and statistics.
Yes.
That's it. And in those statistics, you are asking, you know, people who are 18 and below, and they're naturally going to be like, well, I've not had sex, but maybe I'll just put them out in 14. Yeah, put it in the 14 column. Yeah. There we go.
If you're asking a 16-year-old, hey, have you ever had sex? Yeah, of course I've had sex.
Yeah, I've had loads.
7 girls at once.
I'm swimming in quim.
I'm doing the quim swim. That's a brilliant phrase.
I'm quimming.
I'm quimming.
I'm doing the breaststroke, if you know what I mean. One rather thinks the last breast that you touched was your mother's when you were suckling pont.
Suckling pont. I don't know. I don't know how accurate those kinds of things are. Unless, you know, you're asking older people, like people in their 20s or 30s.
Who have no reason to lie.
They're more likely to tell you the truth.
Yeah.
Especially if it's not in front of your mates.
Not in front of your mates. Not in front of your mates who misses you.
Yeah.
Which reminds me of this is one of the very rare times we will do a joke. Prepare yourselves.
Are you sitting comfortably? Are you ready?
Whoop.
Time for a joke.
Time for a joke. Time for a joke. It's coming out my mouth. Here we go. So a man turns to his wife and he says, can we have a talk about all the sexual partners we've had? Because I just feel it's like something we don't really know about each other. And she turns to him and she goes, yeah, that's absolutely fine. It's, you know, open and honest relationship. Let's go for it. How many have you had? So he goes, well, there's before you were the 3 others, and obviously you're the 4th. So, yeah, 4 women. And she's going, oh, yeah, no, that's perfectly respectful. That's quite nice, really. And, you know, he turns back to her and says, so how about you? And she thinks, and she goes, oh, well, let me just try and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you. 8, 9. That's the joke. And the man's spirit is crushed, and later on in the night, he hangs himself. It's a bleak ending. But. If it's not a too personal question, when did your penis fairy leave you?
My penis fairy.
Penis fairy.
Well,
when
I was.
When did the barrier break?
When did the barrier break? Well, I was a little. I was a bit of a late bloomer.
Oh.
I got to 20.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That surprises me.
Because I'm such a poon hound. Yeah, you should see my bedroom. It's covered in titty pictures and ladies in bikinis.
Yep, the walls are white, and it ain't paint.
It ain't paint. Yeah, I was a late bloomer. I had quite a conservative upbringing. No, not conservative. Religious. I was raised by Methodists.
Ah. Methodists aren't religious. They're the fucking most half-assed thing in the world.
Oh, no. I had many coffee mornings in my youth.
Yeah. They are ultimate pick-and-choose Christianity. It's like, oh, well, yeah, we're not that bothered. I mean, the bit about not being gay. Yeah, when I said that one, obviously. The bit about the whole, like, don't mix your fabrics. Well, come on.
Yeah. So, yeah, compared to some, they're not hardline, but they... Yeah. I had a Christian upbringing.
It's enough. Yeah. I know of two other Methodists, both female, and I think it is probably part of their upbringing that, yeah, well, one of them has chosen not to have sex before marriage, as far as I am aware. The other one tried not to have sex before marriage, and it just kind of happened.
It just kind of happened. Well, this
just
is
kind
thing,
of
yeah.
fall into it, as it were.
The teenage years were interesting. They were a battle.
A battle with oneself.
Often, yes. I eventually got over my my need to please my parents, and also the fact that I realised I don't actually share their religious beliefs.
Yeah.
I can be my own person. It took a little bit of a while to do that, and then.
And now I'm gonna sex a lady.
And then I found myself in a relationship. I was like, it's time to do the thing.
It's time to do the sex act. As I am not getting married to you.
Put this. Let's put this in that place. Put this thing back where it should belong, and then take it out and put it back in, and take it out and put it back in.
Wait, you can put it other places. Wait, what?
Wait, hold on a second.
Wait a second.
Yeah. I was the first time that we had sex together. It wasn't her first time.
Yeah.
But I hadn't...
You and me got the same story.
I hadn't told her this.
Right.
She didn't know.
She figured it out.
No. It was incredibly complimentary. She was like... That was pretty good for our first time. I was like,
"Why, thank you."
If you say so, you'd know.
Turns out this was practice.
Yeah.
Who knew?
Yeah, and then like later on in the relationship, I told her, and she was like, "Oh, okay."
Oh,
well, there you go.
Cool. Well done.
Yeah, I was very pleased with myself in that moment for two very good reasons.
Mm.
One, finally.
Yes, finally.
Finally got to have the sexy thing.
Finally.
Two, it didn't go completely horribly.
I just remember lasting ages because obviously the normal first time sex story is like, oh yeah, three pumps and boom, there goes the petrol.
Yeah.
But me, it was like totally opposite. God, it must have been about an hour and a half or something. It was just... I was completely opposite way, and I was, you know, I was turgid all the time, and it just, nothing would, it was like it suddenly become dead.
Just too much pressure, mate.
It was basically rigor mortis. Yeah. It wasn't...
You're like, oh my god, just the anxiety of the situation.
Yeah,
just,
exactly.
Fell upon you.
Brain just firing off two messages, which was, be stiff, don't come, be stiff, don't come.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah. There's a little window into our lives you never thought you'd hear. All four listeners.
Well, I don't know. They probably, based on our previous topics of conversation, they were probably aware this was going to happen at some point.
It's been coming, if you know what I mean.
If you know what I mean.
Do you have funny sex stories? Hey, email them to us.
Messages on the postcard.
Yep. Messages on leggings, please.
On leggings, yep.
Need something else to masturbate over.
As opposed to, never mind, I don't want to know. There you go. Alright. Have you become a Muppet now?
Alright, Kermit the Frog here.
Kermit. Sometimes I wish I was the great Gonzo. I had that man's hand up my ass.
I think Gonzo knows how to live.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think of all the Muppets, Gonzo is the most, like, he is the liver. He's the one who...
The one who takes the most alcoholic abuse?
Yeah.
Or...
Oh, a bit of both.
Hey, liver.
Hey.
It's a homonym.
Him and Rizzo.
Yeah. Yeah, they have a good time, don't they?
Yeah. They're the chaps.
They're the lads on the town.
As demonstrated in Muppets Christmas Carol.
Absolutely. They know what they're doing there. I like him as a narrator of film. Fuck it, I just like the great Gonzo. I think he is great.
Gonzo. Replace Morgan Freeman with Gonzo, I say.
We'll get him to narrate films from now on.
Let Morgan Freeman be Gonzo.
Oh my god, Morgan Freeman voices Gonzo.
And now the great Gonzo will fly out of a cannon. Wow. Wow.
Which is incidentally also how some people describe losing their virginity. Flying the great Gonzo out of a cannon.
The great Gonzo flew out of the cannon last night,
if you know what I mean. He'd hid his...
This is what you need to do. You need to also edit together all the if you know what I mean. You are not going to have a fun time, but you are going to have a long time, which is also what I said before I lost my virginity.
Well, there you go.
Yes. Right. With that, we shall meander into the sunset.
Yes. Off we go.
I think that's a sunset. It looks fiery. We'll walk into it and we'll see what happens.
If we survive, then good news.
Ladies, always know. Olaf wants you. I do as well, but we just need to be a bit more secretive about it.
Yeah.
Just, you know, under the old hat.
Keep
you know what I mean?
Under the radar.
Also, anal only. That's the rule.
That's the rule.
That's the rule. Not for Olaf. Olaf will take what he can get.
It's true. I probably will at this point.
He'll just... Yeah. If you can just maybe just lightly brush past his penis, that'll...
Not even penis. Could just... Like
just
elbow,
be near my being.
Yeah, just glance in the direction of my knees. I'll probably be fine. Oh, I felt the gaze upon me, which is also...
That's what happened at that club, though.
Yeah, that's what happened at that club. I felt the gaze upon me.
I don't think I'm supposed to be here.
And as you're saying to the ladies, also to the gentlemen, you know.
Yeah. Again, he'll take what he can get.
I'll take what I can get, yeah.
He doesn't discriminate.
That's true, I don't.
Just whatever you are, sit on his face and tell him that you love him.
I'll sit on your face and tell you that I love you too. Or wouldn't it be fine if we could all 69?
If we sit on our faces alone, find our places, and then you'll be blown away. End.
End credits. Yeah, that was good.
We will return.
We shall return.
When you pry our penises out of your cold, dead hands. That's my Charlton Heston NRA speech. But with a penis.
Penis instead of a rifle.
With a penis. You blew it up! You maniacs! You blew it all to hell. Oh, you're blowing it now. Ah! You damn dirty ape.
You damn dirty ape.
Oh, Dr. Zeus. Ah!
Well, thank you, Charlton Heston, for that interesting insight.
Thank you for listening. I don't know where that went.
Not a clue. That just went a bit weird.
Thank you for listening. Is this Montgomery Burns or Vincent Price? I don't know. I'm going to keep doing this until it fades away. Ooh.